Good morning. I am Dr. Perumal. I am happy to welcome you all for the class on Routh test for stability. The Routh test is an analytical method to determine how many roots of the characteristic equation lies on the right half of the complex plane. If the roots lies on the right half, it is unstable. Left half, it is stable. Consider the characteristic equation 1 plus GC GF GP GM equal to 0. Here GC GF GP GM is the transfer function for controller, final control element, process and measuring element. Now we can convert the characteristic equation into a polynomial form like A0 S power n plus A1 S power n minus 1 plus A2 S power n minus 2 plus A3 S power n minus 3 plus etc. An equal to 0. Here A0, A1, A2, A3, An are called as coefficients of polynomial. By analyzing the coefficients of the polynomial, we can determine how many roots of the characteristic equation lies on the right half of the complex plane. We need not find the value of the roots for this characteristic equation. So, to apply this Routh criteria, the system has to satisfy two basic conditions. One is necessary condition and another one is sufficient condition. What is necessary condition? The necessary condition states that all the coefficients A0, A1, A2, A3, An in the characteristic polynomial must be positive. If the coefficients are positive, the system may be stable or may not be stable. Then we have to go for the sufficient condition. If the coefficients, any one of the coefficient is negative, then definitely we can say the system is unstable. No need to go for further analysis. Then sufficient condition. If all the coefficients are positive, we can construct the Routh array like this. In the Routh array, if all the elements in the first column is positive, the system is stable. If any one of the elements in the first column is negative, the system is unstable. Now let us see how we can construct the Routh array. The Routh array is a matrix form. The first two rows will be filled by the coefficients A0 to A1, that is A0, A2, A4, A6 in the first row, A1, A3, that is alternate coefficients. Then the third row, A1, is determined by using this formula, A1 equal to A1, A2 minus A0, A3 divided by A1, that is the cross multiplication as we did in the matrix. Then the next element, A2, while calculating the A2, we have to hide the second column and we have to cross multiply the elements in the preceding column and the next column. Like that, we have to fill all the elements in the matrix. Then further, we have to check whether all the elements in the first column is positive or negative. If the first column is positive, the system is stable. If it is negative, the system is unstable. The number of elements in the negative signs in the first column represents the number of roots which lie on the right half of the complex plane. Then we can define Routh stability criteria. A necessary and sufficient condition for all the roots of characteristic equation to have negative real parts is that all of the elements in the first column of Routh array is positive. If any one of the elements in the first column is negative, the system is unstable. The number of sign changes in the first column will represent the number of roots will lie on the right half of the complex plane. Then summary. Write the characteristic equation in polynomial form. If any one of the coefficient is negative, the system is unstable. No need to proceed further. If all the coefficients of the polynomial are positive, the system is stable. Then construct the Routh array. Check whether all the elements in the first column is positive. The system is stable. The number of negative signs in the first column represents the number of roots which lie on the right half of the complex plane. Thank you.